Only a little over 100 years ago, California was the site of a major explosive eruption that was captured in this photograph. This occurred on May 22, 1915, when pressure and volatiles building beneath Lassen Peak's summit broke through overlying rock, generating a powerful explosion that rapidly sent a plume of ash to an altitude of 10 kilometers or 32,800 feet. As part of the associated eruption column collapsed back to the ground due to its high density, a series of superheated pyroclastic flows quickly incinerated large swaths of adjacent forest, reaching as far as 4 miles away and incinerating a total of 3 square miles of land. Today, this area within Lassen Volcanic National Park is simply referred to as the devastated area. And yet, this was only the most recent example of an eruption from an incredibly long-lived active volcanic complex which has been intermittently erupting for 825,000 years. In that long time span, hundreds of explosive eruptions have occurred from dozens of vents, putting a large-scale volcanic complex with multiple centers of activity during different periods. For reference, Lassen Peak can be found in the northern third of California, where it is 10.5 miles north-northeast of the town of Mineral. Lassen Peak is quite special, as in the vast Cascade Mountain Range, it represents the southernmost active volcano in the range. Its activity is caused by the offshore subduction of the Juan de Fuca plate underneath the North American plate. The melted material from this collision then migrates upwards, intruding into the crust, which sometimes results in eventual eruptions, forming a chain of volcanoes. Before I further discuss this volcano, which contains the largest geothermal area in the entire Cascade Mountain Range, I want to note a difference. Technically speaking, Lassen Peak only describes the large lava dome that produced that complex's most recent eruption. And Lassen Volcanic Center is technically the name of the broader complex. While many distinct volcanic centers have been constructed within Lassen Volcanic Center, consisting of cinder cones, lava domes, stratovolcanoes, shield volcanoes, and a caldera, its overall activity can be distinguished by 3 main phases that constructed larger edifices. The first phase of activity constructed the Rockland Center between 825,000 and 609,000 years ago via an overlapping group of dacite and rhyolite lava domes and their associated tephra. Fed by a very large magma chamber, this would lead to the largest volcanic eruption in the last several million years of the Cascade Range 609,000 years ago, ejecting 250 cubic kilometers of tephra, causing hundreds of feet thick of ash and pyroclastic flows to pile up near the volcano, and devastating an area of more than 1,000 square miles. This eruption formed a vast and deep caldera, but it is no longer visible to us today after being buried by significant amounts of more recent eruptive products. The second eruptive period occurred 590,000 to 385,000 years ago, constructing an 11,500-foot-tall stratovolcano known as Brokeoff Mountain via overlapping layers of basalt to dacite lavas and ash. Large volume flank eruptions occurred in the latter half of the volcano's lifespan, and it would later completely erode away due to intense hydrothermal alteration. The third period began 385,000 years ago and continues to the present, constructing many dacite lava domes in and around the modern Lassen Peak. Lassen Peak proper did not begin to form until 27,000 years ago, when a very large dacite lava dome was constructed across a prolonged eruption with a volume of 2.5 cubic kilometers. In the last 15,000 years, 6 eruptions have occurred from the Lassen Volcanic Center. The first one constructed a cinder cone and associated 3.17 square mile andesitic lava flow 13,000 years ago. In 900 CE, Dome A of the rhyolitic Chaos Crags formed in association with a tephra cone. 70 years later, it was mostly destroyed in a violent explosive eruption. Then, another eruption occurred, constructing 5 more rhyolite lava domes. In 1666 CE, the cinder cone, termed cinder cone, formed in a mildly explosive eruption which formed many lava fountains, eventually emplacing a 3.26 square mile basaltic andesite lava flow. Lassen Peak's summit then produced an eruption from 1914 to 1917 which represented its most recent activity. Since such a large area could be the site of future eruptions spanning 200 square miles, and that many of these eruptions are associated with heavy ash emissions, pyroclastic flows, and lahars, it should come as no surprise that the U.S. Geological Survey designated Lassen Peak as a very high-threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Deanna Moore, for supporting my work.